Kanon is a harem, like it or not. A harem can be briefly described as a genre anime wherein the male protagonist is surrounded by three or more beautiful female characters, all of whom usually have cliché personality traits, and they almost always usually have some type of romantic subplot with said protagonist most of the time. Sometimes they don't, more than likely they do. A good example of a harem anime is the very popular Love Hina, aka Steaming Pile of Donkey Doo, and it is a perfect example of what harem is 95% of the time, which pretty much just is a show that's good for a laugh, but on the grand scheme of things, you could do much better without. Now, Kanon belongs to the other 5%. Azawa Yuichi has just returned to an old snowy town in Japan where he used to spend some of his childhood, after not stepping foot in the place since 7 years prior. Curiously enough, though, he does not remember anything about the town or the people that live there, spare his cousin Nayuki and his aunt Akiko. But as time passes, and he becomes used to his once unfamiliar surroundings, he encounters girls from his past who hold the keys to the lost memories that lay inside of him. Another thing Kanon has on a traditional harem is that harems usually aren't tragic and emotionally involving. What they usually are comedies, and as I said, good for a laugh. Now, this doesn't mean that Kanon doesn't have its fair share of funny moments. It actually has quite a few. But what they are there for is not to be the focus of the story, but rather a cushion for the more depressing parts of the series. With each new story arc comes a new female antagonist with a sad story to tell, usually starting off on a positive and light-hearted note before diving into much deeper and darker themes ranging from unrequited love to attempted suicide and finally, well, death. There's a very good chance that throughout the course of the series you will shed a tear or two, unless of course your heart either is non-existent or happens to be burnt up so much into a cinder that you won't even notice. You poor person, you. So you may be asking, Arcata, you possible heartless bastard, you, how does one survive such a sad and tragic story? The answer to that is simple. There's only one word. That word is moe.
Moe, moe, cute!
Kyoto Animation, the studio that helmed this tragic tissue box of a show, are the pioneers of moe. Not only are they famous for practically inventing the moe genre, but they are also the best at making fun of and utilizing the genre to its greatest effect, among other things they are famous for. In Kanon, all of the designs and the personalities of the female characters practically ooze with cuteness to such a degree that it might actually turn away the prospective viewer. And this is going to be something that you're going to have to deal with if you want to watch the show, because it is there and it is not going away. However, unlike other shows that have moe appearances, cough cough, phantom, cough cough, the moe aspect does not halt or hinder the show in any way. If anything, it helps to relieve the serious tension that the plot has. And it's able to do this because, well, it's freaking moe. Anyways, speaking of, to create the perfect moe character, you need three things. You need the look, you need the personality, and you need the voice. All things must be present to create the perfect moe image. Now, the English dub does not have such an image. Let me show you why. This is moe. This is not.
No, that's not it at all.
You see what I'm saying? The characters in the English dub of Kanon do not sound cute at all. However, they have a good reason for it. It is very rare to find someone in North America that can actually speak and sound cute, and 99% of the people that do are usually faking it. Pretty badly at that. And That's probably the reason why the English dub of Kanon doesn't even try, because they would not be able to succeed in any way, which I'm actually quite grateful for, because no moe is better than bad moe. It is so much better than bad moe. But there are also many people out there that would probably prefer the normal voices rather than the moe voices, which is another reason why they probably did it. And I congratulate them for it. There was absolutely nothing wrong with this dub at all, besides that one aspect, and that is the only reason why I personally would watch sub, because when I watch moe, I want to hear moe. But really, again, there's nothing wrong with the dub. Another thing of note is that this version of Kanon is the 2006 remake of an already existing 2002 version of the same show. The difference being is that this one is twice as long and 1,000 times better looking than the original. And even though I have never seen it personally, I have been assured that the remake is infinitely better than the original in almost every aspect. Now, don't be afraid that you're going to pick up the wrong one by accident, because the original has never been brought over to North America, so you can't buy it. And the only version of any Kanon that you can currently buy in stores right now, because it's in print, is this version by Funimation, which, even though it doesn't state it, is the Viridian Collection, complete with two slim pack volumes, and it's extremely fucking useless and flimsy cardboard case. I hate them. Anyways. So whether or not you're going to pick up this show depends entirely on whether or not you can handle the tragic moe show that it is. And if you can, I highly recommend it to a lot of people, actually. You, for example. You. Yes, you. William. Even though that's probably not your name and I just totally stole that joke. But yeah, so that has been Kanon. Pick it up if you can handle it. If not, don't. You heartless person, you. From the snowy Canadian tundras, even though I'm in the city and there's absolutely no snow, which is completely depressing, stay frosty.
いつまでも、いつまでも、だ